Hey guys, welcome to Get in the Mix. In today's isolation video, we're going to be talking about entry-level keyboards. Now, as I'm sure many of you are experiencing, it's a very slow time at the moment, with people working at home, on leave, on furlough, or just simply not able to leave their house. It's the perfect time to pick up a new hobby or potentially pick back up that hobby that you started before. If you're into production or you're thinking about getting into production and making music, one of the first questions we always get is, well, what do I need? Now, of course, we could do a whole video on studio setups and home setups. And as you can see, my home setup isn't particularly impressive, but I've got what I need here to create music. The bare bones that you would need is some speakers. So here you can see some RP5 monitors behind me. And if you saw our video last week, that's a really great way to kind of have a little look at what monitors might be suitable for you. Be sure to check that video out. The link will be in the description. And of course, you will need an audio interface. So for me, I've got my PreSonus Audio i1, which is routing all my audio from my computer into the monitors. The last and very last thing you will need as bare bones would be a MIDI keyboard. And so in today's video, I'm just going to go over three basic keyboards to get you started and help you make that decision about which keyboard you might buy. So the first one I want to talk about is the Akai MPK Mini. Now, Akai have been making great hardware gear for years. I mean years. I mean, we go back to the 80s, to the old MPCs and the birth of hip hop and the golden era. They've been leading the way for a long time. Now, this keyboard retails at £76. And comes bundled with Hybrid 3 and Wobble, two great synthesizers from Akai, and the MPC Essentials software. It's also not short of features on the unit itself. It features 8 performance pads, 8 mappable potentiometers or dials, as we like to call them, a nice little joystick which could be used for all sorts of things, map that out to whatever you might want, an XYZ pad for instance, a built-in arpeggiator, and of course the 2 octave of keys that we see here. So it's really not lacking in features whatsoever, and a great price point to get you started. Now, the next one I want to talk about is the M32 from Native Instruments. Now, this is one of my favorite keyboards, mainly because I'm a big machine user and I'm a big user of the Native Instruments stuff. And the beautiful thing about this one is it integrates so well with their software and gear that out of the box, you can get some amazing stuff going with this. So, of course, you see across the top here, these really nice Infinity rotary encoders. Now, these are great because, as I said, if you have any Native Instruments sounds, synths, Musing Machine, whatever it might be, or even their plugin inside of Ableton, these will automatically map out to all the different parameters inside that synth, which gives you a really nice way to get hands-on with manipulating your sounds, changing filters, cutoffs, LFOs, all sorts of things you can be kind of manipulated and changed from these. And don't worry, if you haven't got any Native Instruments stuff already, it comes bundled with a lot of stuff. So you get a copy of Monarch, Reactor, I think you get Complete Start. Of course, anyone can get Complete Start, but it comes bundled with that. Contact, Machine Essentials. You're gonna get all sorts of software to get you going. Some great sounds, some piano sounds, all sorts of bits and bobs to really just kind of set you off running from the get-go. It also is riddled with great features, including chord modes, scale modes, arpeggiators, note repeats, and all sorts, again, to really get you flying off the bat. Now, the features on this are very in-depth, and we could do a whole video on it, and in fact, we have done a whole video of it. So if you've not seen it before, be sure to check out our video, the complete tutorial to the M32, and I'll go over all the features inside the unit and kind of just give you an overview of how it works. But another thing I'd like to point out is this real cool 4-way rotary clip encoder that makes it really easy to navigate through your sounds and your browsers. But one last thing that is really important about the purchase of an M32 is that it comes bundled with Ableton Live Lite. Now, Ableton Live is one of the industry standard production DAWs for dance music. It's been my go-to DAW of choice for about 8 years now. You may be able to see it on the camera behind, on the screen behind me. I used to use Apple's Logic, which will always have a very special place in my heart, but I moved on to Ableton because the workflow is just simply unparalleled. Now, if you haven't got any production gear, you are literally a complete beginner, I have never done anything type person, then this is a great choice because it comes bundled with Ableton Live Lite. And this is a stripped back beginner version of Ableton that really will allow you to kind of dip your toes in the water and start experimenting with making music. Now, it is of course limited, so if you've already been using Logic Pro to a for instance, you know, doing a lot of stuff inside that, then you might find it a bit limiting. But if you've done nothing, it's going to be a really great way to kind of jump in, dip your toes in the water, and start experimenting with different sounds. And that comes completely free. And Ableton Live Lite on its own is normally around £60, so it's a really great starting point and a really great option. Now this one's coming in at £89, so still really not breaking the bank, really affordable, really great bit of kit. And the very last thing I'd like to say about it is that the action on these keys is really nice. Now, when we talk about action in keys, we often use and hear the terms weighted, non-weighted, semi-weighted, fully weighted, piano style, hammer style. You have all these different terms that just kind of basically are referencing to the amount of give and weight on a piano key. Now these ones, they describe this as synth weighted. Now I've never really worked out what synth weighted means, but they do feel great. They're not as kind of light as some of the other keyboards. It's got kind of a nice bit of weight to it. You can press it. It's of course not fully weighted. It's not even semi weighted, but it has got a nice bit of resistance there, and they do feel really nice to play. The very last one that I'd like to talk about, it's not over there, is down here, is the Arturia Keystep. Now this one is a little bit of a different beast. If you maybe have already been using some gear, or if you are particularly into outboard hardware gear, this is the way to go. If we flip it round on the back here, we can see we've got a MIDI in and out. We've also got CV controls, a sustain input, a sync in and out, that makes it really great for linking with any hardware gear. So maybe you're into techno and you've seen a lot of your favorite artists using things like the Roland, the 909s, the TB3s, all these different outboard bits of gear, and you're thinking, that's what I want to do. I want to create some music without a computer, completely live. Well, this is the way to go, because it will integrate so well with all the gear that you've got. Again, the weighting on the keys on this one feels absolutely phenomenal. It's got a real nice weight to it, and it's laden with extra little features. Up here you can see that we've got a sync and arpeggiator feature with a rate, a sequencer, was it so? It says this is a sequence and arp mode, a rate division, and a time division, which really gives you some nice parameters to control. We can start creating some arpeggiators, some kind of different aspects of these music to kind of really start getting the ball rolling with creation and making music live. And still, it's got your standard kind of pitch and modulation controls here, and it's got quite a bit of weight to it. It feels really nice. Now, I know today's video has been quite short, but hopefully you've got everything you need to know. Oh, almost forgot the price. £99 for one of those. So still not breaking the bank, still really affordable, and an absolute amazing choice. I hope you've enjoyed today's short video. Hopefully that's everything you might need to know about some of the entry-level controller options. Now, we've got some plenty more content coming your way, and we're going to be trying to keep you as entertained as possible whilst you're at home. Like if you like, chuck us a comment in the comment section, and be sure to subscribe, and make sure to get in the mix.